My name is Lisante Chavez, and I will be speaking about street racing. According to the report, most street racing deaths don't involve the driver, published on March 16, 2018, 47% of people killed in street racing accidents were drivers, while 53% were not. This just goes to show that even people who aren't racing themselves can still be affected by this dangerous activity. Whether you're the driver, passenger, or even a pedestrian, you or someone you know may be in danger and may not even realize it. Some of us may already know someone who races or have already been affected by the outcomes of these decisions, so it's important to realize the risks and consequences involved with street racing. The risks involved can not only affect the drivers, but the people around as well. I've researched and gathered what I found to be important, and I will share my research to raise awareness for our safety. I will be discussing dangers and risks of street racing, and I will also provide solutions for street racers to help redirect them to make safer decisions. I would like to start off with the biggest risk involved with street racing. Street racing is a very dangerous and highly illegal activity that can harm many people and can even cause death. Imagine a car racing on the city street. It can be so easy for the driver to lose control and cause an accident. Something can go wrong with the vehicle, like a tire going out, you hit a bump on the road, or even losing traction. There are so many little things that can go wrong that can make a big difference in someone's life. This would not only affect the driver, but the people around as well. If something goes wrong, it has the potential to change people's lives, if not end them. Now that I've explained a few risks and problems with street racing, I would like to go over some reasons why people race. Some people might race for money, other people race for the thrill. Some people race just to compare their cars to each other. It may sound crazy, but some people race because of tradition. In Japan, there's a style of racing called Kanjo racing. I'll play a clip explaining a little bit of what Kanjo racing is.
A 7.68 kilometer long loop of connected highways that encircle the city of Osaka. For most, it's their daily commute. For some, it's another noisy highway that runs through the middle of their neighborhood. But for the Kanjozoku, it's the loop where friendships and rivalries are formed. Welcome to their automotive playground.
Kanjo racing is dangerous because they race in between traffic. If two cars are driving next to each other, the racers might try to go around them or even in between the vehicles. You might be thinking, well, that's in Japan, it's not in the United States. But the truth is that the United States car culture is highly influenced by the Japanese car culture. These racers can put people in danger all over the United States. I'll play another clip explaining a little bit of why they race, which I'm sure can relate to racers all over the world. Nobody should put themselves or anybody else in that type of danger. Now that I've shared some reasons why people race, I'd like to go over some solutions for the street racers. The best solution for the average street racer is a drag strip.
It's on the video.
drag strip allows for two cars to race one-on-one. Some people don't even care to race another car. The drag strip records the amount of time it takes from each car to cross the finish line, allowing cars to track their time and try to beat their own records. For racers like the Conjo racers, I recommend going to organized and legal track events. There are racetracks and events made specifically for this type of racing. In conclusion, street racing is a very dangerous and illegal activity that can change and end the lives even if they aren't behind the wheel. Drag strips and tracks are made to keep racers on tracks and people on roads safe. By going to legal events and drag strips, we can help keep everyone safe on the road and even save lives.